The following is a non-profit, fan-based entertainment series. The Mass Effect Trilogy is owned by BioWare and Electronic Arts. Please support the official release.
Shepard, I thought we could experience an afternoon of acquiring material possessions for our associates.
Shopping? I guess we could. Did you have a place in mind?
Physical proximity is unnecessary. The extranet provides a greater variety of services while retaining entertainment value. Jeff has lent me his credit chit on the condition that I enjoy myself and, quote, live it up like a girly girl.
Huh. You don't have money of your own?
I am not formally employed. I have no legal standing in Citadel space. I could turn to crime, but that would look bad on a resume.
We'll get you your own fun sometime, but today, what's first?
I believe Jeff would be surprised and pleased if I got him a gift. What would you recommend?
Start with something both of you can enjoy. What do you do together?
We interact most closely when we are flying. It occurs to me that he does not have a sky car for traveling around the Presidium. Here, the 2187 Blackout has a top speed of 650 kilometers per hour, making it the most powerful sports sky car in its class.
That sounds like it'll get Joker's blood pumping.
5-year warranty? Replacement parts?
No, wait!
I fail to see what is wrong.
When you buy someone a present, it's best not to bankrupt them. You want a rental.
I see. Perhaps for a day or a weekend, then.
Who's next?
You are. Close your eyes.
Are we getting married?
No. There is a jeweler on the Citadel who produces these. They're made from metals from each council homeworld. Each metal compounds with the last, making the rings stronger. He calls them victory rings. Due to material shortages, only a few exist.
Rare is nice. Unique is better.
Are you valuing me?
It's the thought that counts, and you had a good one.
I have heard that expression. That's why I recorded a resonance map of my quantum bit arrays when I had the idea. If you read my extensive log files and extrapolate from my nitrogen vacancy centers, you can visualize the thought precisely.
That's a long way for a joke, Edie.
Did I have you for a few seconds there?
Not even close. Who's next?
I was thinking of something for Liara.
Greetings, Commander.
Shepard.
I didn't know you could play.
Actually, this is the only song I know.
Why is that?
There was always something more important to do. A ruin to uncover, intel to gather, a commander to save.
Ha! You couldn't sit still long enough.
Could you?
Is there something special about this song?
On one of my first digs, a storm swept in. We were trapped inside. I was so restless. I wanted to get back to work. One of the other archaeologists, Dr. Olena, had this keyboard. She took it everywhere. She taught me to play this song while we waited.
It's a good song.
Thank you, Shepard. The person who taught me that song was a friend. I spend so much time chasing down knowledge. Sometimes I forget that there are things you learn by doing nothing. By just spending time with the people you care about.
What have you learned from me?
I suppose, how to get myself into life-threatening situations on a daily basis.
I'm a good teacher.
The best. Well, I should probably go. I have reports to look over.
Right. But first, why don't you teach me that song? Miranda, good to see you. How do you like the place?
Not a part of town I'd normally associate you with, Shepard. I like it. Fix me something while you're back there, would you?
Sure. I'll get just the thing. So what brings you back?
I was hearing some confusing reports. Sounded like you had lost your mind.
No doubt. My communications were hacked, among other things. I'm sure the news had a field day.
It did. So, a clone?
Yeah. Saw it myself. Did you know anything about this?
Just rumors. Nothing really caught my attention. But about this Brooks.
Heard anything?
Not as Brooks, but as Hope Lilium. Another lie, certainly. When the Collectors showed up, she put together the dossiers on your crew for the elusive man. Never paid her much mind. Interesting. My focus at the time was bringing you back. We needed the real Shepard, not some cheap knockoff. I mean, really? A clone?
Yes. Hard to imagine.
I'm not sure the galaxy could survive two Shepards. Think of the property damage. Oh, they shut down my favorite sushi place.
That's a shame.
Shepard, you didn't.
I did. Fell right through the fish tank.
How did you manage that?
It exploded. Hey, it was the clone's plan, not mine.
Blowing up a fish tank shouldn't be part of anyone's plan. Although executing marine life seems to be some sort of hobby with you. No wonder your clone couldn't resist.
It was the first step in taking over my whole life. We stopped it.
Good thing, but why did it want your life? Why would anyone? All that running, jumping, gunfire. It's crazy.
I try not to think about it.
Probably for the best.
Trust me, I know all this isn't normal.
Speaking of trust, with all this clone business, how do I know you're the real Shepard?
I don't know, you just do.
Do I? That's the trouble with clones. You can never be sure.
Come on. You rebuilt me from almost nothing. Don't you recognize your own handiwork?
It's not as if I carved my initials in the corner.
Well, clone or not, I'm the only Shepard left.
Good point. I guess I'm stuck with you.
I do have a crazy life, don't I?
That you do, my friend. That you do.
Hey, Shepard, I'm starving. What do you got?
We're heading out, Caden.
We'll just end up back here anyway. Am I right? Trust me. Let me impress you.
Oh, no, really?
Come on!
You want me to sit there and watch you cook?
You're not watching me cook, you're helping me drink beer. Now sit your ass down.
What are we having? Canadian delicacy of some sort?
Sure. Exactly. We have, beef, we have bacon, we have beer. The foods of my people. Wish me luck. You like to cook, Shepard?
Roommate on Arcturus taught me. He said eating cafeteria crap 24/7 was bad for morale.
Is there anything you're bad at?
Where'd you learn to cook?
Class is a jump zero, believe it or not. Young biotics who can't cook for themselves risk starving.
Did you pass? You're burning the garlic.
Sorry. Guess I'm distracted.
By?
I wonder. So?
We have hot sauce, right?
This was great.
What? Is it over?
Well, what do you suggest?
I can't think of anything better than this moment right now.
You're mine, you bastard. God damn it.
Zaid?
Over here, Shepard. This thing is fucking impossible.
What are you doing?
There was a kid here. Sniveling brat. Spending all his credits. Crying.
So you thought you'd get a prize for him?
He asked. Looked simple enough. God damn it.
Where's the kid?
What do I care? Got any credits, Shepard?
Isn't there something better we could go do?
What could possibly be more important than Zaid Masani not getting bested by some fucking kid's game?
You really want one of those plushy toys?
Goddamn right I do.
Okay, then.
Credits.
Sure. But even a bounty hunter's gotta use his manners once in a while.
Please.
Easy, easy.
It's obviously rigged somehow.
Rigged?
I'm going to hunt down the shit for brains inventor of this crooked game and pull his inspiration out through his asshole. Probably some smart-ass Salarian bastard. I'm going back in. Credits. All right. Here you go, sweetheart.
Okay, Zaid, where to?
How should I know? What do you feel like? Apollo's? Casino? More claw?
Zaid, will another victory ever match the one you just experienced?
You're right. Guess you've been around that block a few times.
A few too many.
Come on, you're buying.
Yes, I am.
Did you catch the other?
Shepard?
So what do Turians usually do with their time off?
Mostly we make plans for what to do when we're back at work. I have some ideas on the Normandy's forward cannon.
You know what you need, Garrus?
That Mark IV silencer scope I saw at the gun shop?
I was thinking a date. Excuse me, I saw you checking out my friend here. I thought you two should meet.
Hello?
Right. So, hello, and,
Tell her she looks nice.
You seem like a nice person. Maybe a little quiet, introspective, but decent, overall.
Oh, thank you, I think.
Small talk.
Come here often. I imagine anyone who does is probably an alcoholic.
Actually, I do. I work at the Turian Embassy. Come here to unwind. Yeah. Well, listen. I've got this thing I forgot I had to do, and I should probably just go do it.
Sorry. Let's start over again. What I've been trying to say is my name's Garrus, and I'd love to have a drink with you.
Hannah Shepard here.
Hi, Mom.
Oh, honey. Oh, it's so good to hear your voice.
This is a surprise. It's been a long time.
It has. I just felt I needed to... I think about you every day. I try not to worry. The other day, I was remembering the bedtime stories we used to make up. You had your own ship and crew. The stories were always filled with adventure and danger.
Yeah. Huh. I haven't thought about that in a while.
Me neither. Oh, you'd always swoop in to punish the bad guys to save the day. So, there you are. Even when you were little, you dreamed of the life you have.
Is that the reason you wanted me to call?
No. I just want you to know that I am proud of you, honey. So proud.
I came as quickly as I could. What's wrong?
I didn't mean to worry you. When I saw you were on the Citadel, I wanted to see you again.
We've said our farewells, Shepard.
Are we gonna stand on formalities? These big picture windows remind me of our talks in the Normandy's observation lounge.
This view doesn't have quite the same effect as a galaxy of stars, but I can see where it might make one sentimental. I also enjoyed our talks, Shepard. Very much.
Hey, look what I found. An old issue of Justicar Heroes, May 2140. It says that you personally lifted 50 refugees across a raging floodplain on Nivos after smugglers blew up a dam.
That news source has been known to exaggerate.
So you didn't almost drown while saving a child who'd been torn from her mother's grasp?
The smugglers were not so lucky that I survived.
Are there more stories like this?
Perhaps. You might be amused by the June 2085 issue, Justicar Samara, Cold-Blooded Justice Runs Hot. It is not so difficult for me to find stories of your exploits. I think that you are remarkable, Shepard. When the vids sing your praises and call you a hero, does it make you blush? Do you agree? What do you feel?
It's humbling. But honestly, if people feel that I'm making a difference, that bolsters me, my team, and our efforts. What now?
I am content as we are, Shepard. Let us sit a while longer, even if there is nothing to say.
We are gathered here to honor the life of Thane Krios. Thane touched each of our lives in different ways. The Counselor knew him as a hero. The Normandy's crew knew him as a brother in arms. And others, as a father devoted to his son. Though his life took him to very dark places, Thane cared for the better angels of our nature. Even when he was terminally ill, he ran through war-torn streets to reach me, because he knew I needed help. You all know the results of that day. An assassin, a professional criminal, gave his life for his galaxy. And now he can rest. Would anyone else like to speak?
What I remember about Thane was his confidence. He told me once about how he remembered everything, even every mistake he made, If I did that, I'd be a nervous wreck. Thane kept it under control.
It's strange, but the last word I'd label Thane with is assassin. And we covered each other in firefights. That makes him a partner.
Thane's last stand was important. But let us also remember why Thane left the Normandy. To keep his son away from a life of crime. Deeds such as these do not go unnoticed by the universe. They echo in all who hear them. That is why I am here.
Thane took himself seriously, a trait with which I did not always agree. I tried to make him laugh on several occasions. But what I interpreted as a lack of humor was masking a great effort. Thane was turning his life around in a way few organics do.
The day Thane came onto the Normandy, all Kelly and I knew about him was that he could probably kill us all with a ballpoint pen. But after you got to know him, there wasn't any reason to be afraid. He let you know where you stood. Colliat, do you,
When I was little, I thought my father had it all figured out. He said men must be loyal to their friends and dangerous to their enemies. But when he prevented me from hurting someone, he had changed. He said enemies and ego are not as important as loved ones. I didn't want to hear it. I was lost. I called him a hypocrite in a thousand different ways, said that he was going soft. Now, I think maybe he did have it all figured out. That's all I can say. If anyone would like to continue, we'll be here.
Looks like people are starting to clear out.
Commander, thank you for holding this event. In time, it will be a good memory.
I don't know if I'll be as philosophical about it. It's still kind of raw.
I understand. If you will excuse me, I should take this opportunity to speak with the counselor.
About what?
He is feeling grateful, and I want to point out there are some Salarian biologists who need funding. If anyone would be able to create a breakthrough in the treatment of Kepler syndrome, it would be them.
If you need someone to hold the counselor's feet to a fire, I'm there.
I appreciate the offer, but Counselor Valern has recently orated about funding science during wartime. My odds are good. Oh, before I go, I was organizing my father's possessions, and I came upon copies of video messages he tried to send you. I sent them to your extranet address. I hope they help more than they hurt. Until we meet again, Commander.
Shepard, I suppose I should thank you for my freedom. Leaving the Normandy was the right decision. It was saddening to see our crew go their separate ways, but it is better than answering questions in an Alliance interrogation room. I hope this message finds you well. As for me, I have moved into an apartment on the Citadel not far from Colliat. I think the first attack I had frightened him. I will spare you the details. It seemed very dramatic at the time. But in comparison to the Omega Relay, it was a child's game. In any case, good luck getting the Alliance to listen to you. Let's keep in touch. Shepard, if you sent a message back, I didn't get it. I suppose communications from someone of my reputation would be restricted. The irony is, I am a danger to no one these days. I am even paying taxes on my investments. I can't expect Kolyat to do so if I don't. He is doing better. He has no significant other, and he is temperamental. But he is employed and staying out of crime. I can tell he is serious about changing. It has cost him more than a few friends. Send something back if you can, Shepard. I can only learn so much from news reports about you. I have tried a false identity to try to get this message through to you. We'll see if it works. I have good news and bad. The good news is that Kolyat and I took a few days to visit Earth.
Light the shade of her eyes. Shrill sound of chirping stops. I scan the ground. See two tiny bodies locked by claws.
Excuse me. As I was saying, we saw a beautiful sunset in New Mexico, and a scorpion eating a cricket. I wish you could have joined us. The bad news is, I fainted and struck my head. Kolyat has convinced me to stay at Huerta Memorial on the Citadel. I will be there from now on. I still don't want to die in a hospital, but it's where the doctors are. And Kolyat. I love him. That means I must trust him. Goodbye, Shepard. Let me say that now, in case I cannot later.
Someone requested my presence concerning an incident with the Krogan?
Right this way, Commander.
So, Grunt, anything you want to tell me about?
This clown wants to take me to lockup. Figured I'd give you a call, straighten this out.
Commander Shepard, I apologize for the intrusion. This Krogan insisted we contact you.
It's okay. I vouch for him. I'll sign any paperwork you have, officer.
Yes, ma'am.
What happened?
I don't know. Drank a bit, left the hospital, broke a few windows.
But you were in that hospital recovering from the Rachni encounter.
Yeah, didn't feel like sticking around.
Most people stick around long enough to, you know, heal.
Most people aren't me.
And why is C-Sec here?
Guess they're precious about some broken glass.
Before I sign you out, everybody walked away from this in one piece, right?
Sure, yeah, everybody's fine. Hospital's seen better days, though.
Right. Tell me about the windows.
A couple of squad mates broke me out for my birthday. Tried lowering me down the side of the building on a rope. It didn't work out.
It's your birthday?
No. I'm tank bred, remember? Anyway, we got some pictures on the Krogan Memorial.
In the Presidium?
Yeah. When C-Sec got there, they were mad. Or maybe they were mad about their car being on fire. Can't remember.
Why was it on fire?
I threw my bottle of Rincol at it. Pretty strong stuff. Went up like a bonfire. The C-Sec guys jumped out. Then I figured they didn't want it, so I took it. We didn't get very far before they shut us down. Sprayed us down with riot foam. Didn't work so well on me.
And why is that?
'Cause I was on fire, you know, from the car. Come on, Shepard, keep up.
Right, sorry. So how did they catch you?
Got hungry, bought some noodles.
Let me handle this. Officer, this Krogan is part of a secret Spectre task force. Operation Fire Cobra Claw.
Operation Fire Cobra Claw?
That's right. I can take it from here. Send me the bill for any damages.
That's what you've been signing for, Commander. You're lucky, Krogan. Don't let me catch you up here again.
You won't. Thank you, officer. So, how were those noodles?
A little spicy.
I love you, Grant. Miranda.
Cute outfit, Shepard. Perfect. Thought we might try an evening out.
Sounds like you have some time to catch your breath.
I do, just not used to it. Feeling a bit lost. It's kind of sad, really. I got to thinking we needed a break. No point saving the galaxy if we can't enjoy it once in a while.
I have to say I'm a bit surprised.
I thought you might be. I can be, severe.
You're focused. Believe me, I understand.
I was thinking about our talk earlier, about having a normal life. Damn, I'm not very good at this. Truth is, Shepard, I'm not very good at being normal either. Bit of a disaster, really.
I get it. We just need a little practice.
Any ideas?
The only difference between us and everyone else is that our to-do list is longer. We need to let that go tonight.
Let it go? That's harder than it sounds.
I know, but this is the perfect place to try.
Here? It's nothing but alcohol, gambling, and wasting time. Right. Need more wine.
Now you're talking. Waiter, more wine.
Oh, God. I'm gonna regret this.
We're a couple of girls out on the town. What's the worst that can happen? Come on, partner. Let's start some trouble. Hey, come on in. Thanks for coming.
Thanks for the invite.
Make yourselves at home.
Thank you.
Happy to be here, Shepard.
Yeah, I'll try.
Did you really just
nice ink. But you got a long way to go to catch up.
Nah, I just got this when I lost my squad a few years ago.
I have no idea what you're on about.
Hey, Shepard. You gonna have a drink?
Sure. How's everyone doing?
Great so far. This is really nice.
It's great.
Quiet.
After the excitement of the mission, it's a good quiet, right?
But if it got a little crazier, I'd be okay with that.
Relax, the night is young. I like it like this.
You got it, boss. I'm just happy to be kicking back.
Nice!
I can't get over the size of this apartment. The electric bill alone could have paid for my college tuition. Or funded the war.
So, Shepard, keeping the hard liquor under lock and key?
Otherwise, I'd have to drive you all home.
Are we sure the Normandy is still there? Has anyone else tried to steal it?
Stealing the Normandy? Now there's an idea.
Wait. What? Who?
Exactly. Trainer, you still have your toothbrush?
We can always get another Normandy. Call up Cerberus and ask them to please build us the SR-3.
But wouldn't that require you to change your name? Tali'Zorah von Normandy SR-3.
It's Voss Normandy. Even I get confused by Quarian names sometimes.
Is that a joke?
We've seen a lot of good times on the old girl.
That we have. Indeed.
Hear, hear.
Some of you more than others. I'm just honored to have squeaked in.
To the Normandy.
You guys are the best.
You know why Cerberus is gonna lose? Demographics. You recruit a guy who's 20 and got no life, he'll work his ass off. You know, I miss the days when Cerberus was just hilariously incompetent. You know, when you two ran things.
Excuse me?
The only thing I was in charge of was the Lazarus Project, which, you will note, was very successful.
Hey, Commander, this is Cerberus. We were studying some Rachni, and they got loose and killed all our guys. Can you take care of that? It's one system over from where we hooked some guy up to the Geth, who then got loose and killed all our guys.
They did rack up quite a body count. And at least back then, it was usually their own bodies.
We knew some cells were bad, but the Alliance and the Council weren't doing anything. And we were doing good work.
And crunches. Lots of crunches.
Hey, not okay, Kasumi.
But we did bring Commander Shepard back.
And after taking down the collectors, I cut ties with Cerberus, got loose, and started killing all their guys.
For which we thank you.
Jeff, do you remember that I am also a Cerberus project?
Oh, crap.
Unexpected. And fun. Let's talk. More action.
Prothean gatherings were nothing like this. We considered the future and respected the dead.
Sounds boring.
So who is strongest, you or the tank bred?
Yeah, I'm plenty curious myself.
What'd I miss?
The Prothean here wants to know who would win in a fight between me and Rex.
You gotta admit, Shepard, it's a good question.
It is a good question.
No, it isn't. Baby Pyjek here wouldn't stand a chance. Don't listen to this fossil. The only thing he could defeat is a glass of warm milk. I got head lice bigger than you, Junior.
We should leave these two lovebirds alone.
Let's not. I'd rather not buy new furniture.
Oh, you think so? That's it.
That's what I meant.
Check it out.
No, really.
Are you serious?
Your guests appear to be enjoying this relaxed atmosphere. Would you like me to keep everything at its current intensity?
I think it's time to turn things up a bit.
I will arrange for up-tempo music and additional cocktails right away, Commander.
I heard there's a big party in there. Can we come in?
Pizza?
How's it going over here?
You can't come in. It's going good.
I see that. Anyone interesting trying to get in?
Not really, no. Get lost. No.
Can I try that?
Sure. Press this button and say no.
No.
Great work.
Felt good. Thanks.
No. See? Easy.
Keep up the good work.
Will do. I told you already. No! Yes, I like pie. And no, you can't come in.
Those never know what hit them.
Worst planet to get shot down over? We're talking pre-war?
Pre-war, life-bearing worlds only.
Hey, guys. Talking shop?
No worries. This is fun for us. So, you don't have a sidearm under your pilot's chair?
The weapons locker is on the bridge, practically right there.
A weapon you can't get to is no weapon at all. When's the last time you trained with a handgun?
Sometime before I got the ass-kicking robot as my co-pilot.
That's no good. What if you have to save Edie someday?
Unacceptable. You should always train. Pilots are warriors, too.
You know what this is? It's a man emergency. Take this kid out back and make him do target practice.
Exactly. Impossible. Some range time will fix you up. Right, Commander?
You are not taking me shooting. My testosterone levels are plenty high. I fly a deadly war machine, remember?
Joker, I'm surprised at you. What about the collector attack? The bridge can get dangerous.
Hey, they totally proved my point. If I'd fired off a shot then, I would have been mobbed. The real weapon is your brain. Take that away, you got nothing.
It still would have been nice to have a little backup at the sushi bar.
You know, there's a combat simulator on the Citadel.
Hell no. Maybe a shooting range if we're not letting this go. Maybe. But not while I'm wasted or hungover.
Hungover is the perfect time to train. Makes you angry at every loud noise.
No. Cortez, you're on. If you're in condition to take me there, you can. But tonight, you gotta match me shot for shot.
Hey, sweetheart. We never really talked about it, but you and me.
Hello, Shepard. Zaid was just keeping me company.
Hello there.
You're admiring the art?
Beauty, as they say, is in the eye of the beholder. Hey, Shepard. Hey, beautiful.
What do you think, Samara?
Hang on. Don't get all snooty on me. I didn't say I didn't like it. I do like it, actually.
If I'm completely honest, I'm not sure what it is. I like the way the colors blend and the depth of the... Actually, I have no idea what I'm saying.
It makes me feel uneasy. Like when you're alone in the dark, lying in wait, and the cold wind brushes across your face like the kiss of death.
Huh. You are a complicated individual, Zaid Masani.
You bet your sweet Azari ass.
Oh, I really need to avoid Derry.
Absolutely. Biotics are impressive. I'm not saying they aren't.
You're just saying that they're not that impressive.
Hey, what's going on here? Everyone playing nice?
Of course, Shepard. James was just explaining how physical conditioning trumps biotics.
Really? You going there, James?
Come on, Lola, you have to go with me on this one. Biotics are strong, but unpredictable. All that cooling down.
Shepard, where did you find this guy?
A person can improve their physique, but biotics, they are what they are. And what about our poor friends stuck with flawed implants?
Wait, what? You're not talking about me, are you? I mean, I may be L2, but I've worked very hard. And now I can read.
Really? That's... no.
That's a bit strange.
Okay. Maybe it's not conditioning exactly. Maybe it's just the condition of one James Vega. Hey, Liara. Check it out. This guy here never has to cool down. In fact, the hotter, the better.
Wait, we're still talking about combat, right?
Hilarious.
Just hush and do some sit-ups.
Kasumi.
Just looking.
Ugh, goddess.
This is unexpected.
I'm gonna have to go with James on this one.
Oh, thanks, Shepard.
Biotics are a little intangible when there's an example of physical excellence standing in front of you.
Nice.
Wow, Shepard. Did you really just say that?
Don't worry, Caden. Your kind of physical excellence is still my kind of physical excellence.
Check it out. I can also roll my tongue.
Oh, my. That's... Shepard, if that's your decision, I support you. Always. James, please stop doing that.
Hey, need me to do anything? Food run, change the music, check on ice.
I need you to relax and have a good time.
Okay, you're the boss. Except when you're not. And, in that case, find me later.
Specialist trainer, may I ask you a question?
You could ask me anything, Edie.
What's wrong, you two?
I am asking Specialist Trainer about why she found my voice sexually attractive.
This is a really good cheese, Shepard. I put some in through the filters. Is it organic?
On one occasion, You said that you wanted to, quote, pin my voice against the wall and run your tongue along its collarbone.
Well, there's a context there that... You were talking about quantum entanglement, and I didn't know you were an AI. There's some kind of herb in the cheese that I can't quite place. Is it sage or basil? Anyway, I was just joking. You know, stress of the retrofits and...
Really? My diagnostic suggested that you were genuinely aroused.
It's really rare to get herbed dextro cheeses. The Turians almost never bother.
You have diagnostics. Cerberus programmed you to check body language. I get more reliable results measuring pupil dilation and thermal readings of erogenous zones.
Oh, good lord. Oh, wait, this is dextro cheese, right? Keila, did I forget to scan the cheese? This is why I don't drink.
Fair's fair, Trainer. Edie has a right to ask about what you said.
I was very interested in Trainer's ability to develop sexual feelings for what was, at the time, a bodiless voice.
You are all terrible. Edie, I apologize for saying that I wanted to roll naked with your voice in satin sheets.
Oh, I was not offended. In fact, it was flattering.
Even the part where I wanted to grab your voice by the hair and nibble my way down its back.
I do not, in fact, remember you saying that, Samantha.
Oh, that wasn't out loud. Never mind. Don't mind me. I'm just going to run a toxin treatment program so I don't die.
Your guests appear to be enjoying themselves, Commander. What shall I do now?
Let's turn up the music and get some people dancing.
Very good, Commander. I have had little opportunity to use my bounce and spin functionality.
Anyone counting? Miranda?
Shepard. What's up?
Just demonstrating a little physical supremacy.
But can you do that with a drink and a snack in each hand?
Sure. Ugh. Wow.
Why is Caden lapping you?
Don't act so surprised.
Jacob is showing you up. How come?
What do you mean? This is my thing, baby.
Seem a little slow tonight, James.
Well, nobody's perfect. How's it going on your end?
Oh. Okay, now. Let's find a more fun way to get sweaty.
Come on, let's dance.
Wonderful party, Shepard. I'm pleasantly surprised. Yeah, it's nice, isn't it? Glad you came. Strange to see everyone in one place. Perfect, really.
Woo! You should bring out those moves more often, Trainer.
You and I don't.
Captain on deck!
Has she always been like this?
Shepard is saving the galaxy. You have to forgive a few eccentricities.
It's very enthusiastic.
It is impressive.
We should record this and broadcast it for the Reapers. They'll either run away, melt down, or fall in love.
Good to see some things don't change.
Well, I like it, Commander. It's good to see you cut loose now and then.
Thank you for all your loyalty and support.
Jeff.
Yes, Edie.
At social events like this, it is customary to dance with friends or loved ones. Would you dance with me?
So he won't dance with you, huh?
Hello, Shepard. You will not.
Well, I will.
No. Seriously, though, don't go there.
Well, then maybe you should dance with her.
Other people are dancing, Jeff.
Yes, they are. And I am sitting here enjoying my drink.
Joker.
No.
Come on.
No.
Seriously?
Ugh, fine.
Dancing during wartime wastes precious energy.
Can't dance myself. I move like a greased one-legged varan. Not a pretty picture.
Okay, I'm ready. Down.
You got it.
What's going on over here?
Shepard! Found something to shoot.
Yeah, I can see that.
It's okay. We're all professionals here. Some of us with no depth perception, but it's fine.
Don't worry. This happens at Krogan parties all the time.
And yet I'm still not comforted. Probably best I walk away now.
As you wish.
Dancing is often considered pleasurable, Jeff.
For me, well...
Hey! Everyone! Come over here for a minute. Let's get a photo to remember this. Arrange yourselves on the sofa.
An excellent suggestion, Shepard.
Great idea! I want a copy.
Make way! Make way!
Thanks for coming, everyone. Here's to us. Ready, Glyph?
Of course. If you could all please direct your attention this way.
Okay. Everyone say Normandy.
Normandy.
Oh, what a night. But look who's here.
Morning.
It is. Be so nice to lie here all day with you. Let's see if anyone else is up.
Duty calls, huh? Even with a hangover?
There's still a war on.
Unless the Reapers are on shore leave, too?
I'm guessing they're not. Round everyone up, pass out the aspirin, and have them report to the Normandy.
You got it.
We better get back to it.
At least we threw one hell of a party. Probably the last one.
Shepard, you will find a way to win. I know it. And when you do, I'll be waiting. Yeah. Greatest challenge of my life. And the greatest reward. It's been a good ride.
best.